everyone. First of all, I want to wish you all a very happy, healthy and creative 2021. And so after all the Christmas and New Year's joy, I felt the need to make some art again. So in this video you will see me make 4 resin geode coasters again, but this time with a nice crystal effect in the middle of the coasters. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin in this case, but also tutorials of acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink and a lot more other tutorials, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So I already started with pouring some resin in my geode coaster mold. I started with one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the Blackbird. And now I'm pouring an alcohol ink in the color Baya Blue. And I also added some Sparkle White to give it a nice sparkle. Also one of my own natural mica pigments. And in the middle you see some crystal inlay molds. They are also silicon and I made them myself, so I'm very proud of myself to create that nice crystal effects what I mentioned before. So they are not the same size, they are different sizes, so I'm very curious how this works and if it turns out beautiful, because I want to create that crystal effect in the middle. So it's not taped or whatsoever. I just laid those silicon crystal molds in the middle and we will see what happens. Now I'm using a paste. And this paste is a test, because I want to add some pigment paste colors to my Just Paint line. And this one is a nice blue color, light blue color. And I added it in a Ziploc bag and now I'm making some designs. So not on top of the crystal silicon molds, only on the outside. And on top of that, I'm using a white paste, also a test, because I also want to add this white paste to my pigment line. Because then I have a combination of mica pigments, but also pigment pastes. Because you can create other effects with pastes. That's why I'm testing these. And on top of the white, I'm using the alcohol ink again, the Baya Blue, with the Sparkle White in it, to push those colors down to create a nice effect on the other side of the coasters. Again, some white. And so far I'm pleased with the pigment paste. They mix very well in resin. So that's good. But now I want to see how they work in the resin. What, how they look. And the silicon mold I'm using is from Molds and Shapes. If you are interested in one of their silicon molds, the information is in the description box with the link to their Facebook page. And I think they are also working on a website, so that's great. So all the information to the silicon mold, because they are amazing, you can find in the description box below this video. So now I'm pouring on top of the crystal silicon molds, and I'm using a Bombay ink, the turquoise color, and in the middle I'm pouring now some clear resin. There you can see it. So hopefully this will work. And I will get the... Yeah, I can remove the inlay crystal silicon molds very easy. But yeah, that we will see later in this video. Now I'm using the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And I'm using the Resin Pro Art Pro resin. Because with this resin I can pour up to 1 centimeter. And that's great. Because the depth of these of this silicon geode coaster mold is 1 centimeter. And I also have a promo code for that website from Resin Pro. If you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount on all their websites. So that's great. Also, the information to that is in the description box. And what I already experienced is that I, I'm now pouring on top of the crystal molds, and so the design, is going away. What I made with the white paste and with the blue paste. So the next time I will pour on the outside of the crystal mold higher, so that the design will not get ruined. But yeah. This is the first time, it's an experiment, so maybe I will get some nice effects on the other side of the coasters, who knows. Again, some Bombay ink in the turquoise color. And to fill all these coasters, I used a little bit more than 400 gram, but after I demold them or take them out of the mold, they will also get a nice heat resistant layer. So also for that layer I used the Resin Pro Top Pro resin, and it's heat resistant up to I think 220 degrees, so that's nice. And I used for that 90 gram. So not a lot resin used for 4 coasters. In a nice thickness of 1 centimeter. And I also want to mention that I made a new Facebook group. And this Facebook group is for all people that use my mica pigments or flakes in their art. And that can be in resin, acrylics, soap, candles, cosmetica, nail art, and a lot more. And yeah, I made this group because I want to see how my mica pigments and flakes are be used in all of your art. And it's an international learning and sharing group where we can support and learn from each other. So come to my group and join me, because I'm very curious what you all make with my pigments and flakes. So we are 24 hours later and the coasters are almost dry. They are still a little bit bendy, so I need to watch out. And I'm going to take them out of the mold, so I'm starting with the first one. I'm very curious if I can take the crystal molds out very easy, but we will find out. So the first one is already out. So now to the second one. And this side looks very pretty, so hopefully I also have a nice backside of the coaster. But I would use the coasters on this side, because the other side there is a dip in the coaster because of the silicon crystal mold. So the last one, no problems with taking them out of the mold. I didn't use a torch, so if you use a torch then you have a risk that the resin will stick to your silicon mold. So that's why I'm not using a torch. So they are out of the mold. Now onto the other side where I need to take out those crystal molds. There you can see it. And they are nice transparent. I like that. So with a stick, I'm taking them out very carefully. There you can see it. And then we can see the effect. And it looks great. Just like a real crystal. There you can see it. So at the end of this video, a close-up, then you can see it much better. Again, I'm using my wooden stick. Goes very easy. It looks very pretty, very sparkly, just like a real crystal. This one is a little bit larger. Very nice. And this is the largest one. Yeah, you need to be very careful that you don't damage the silicon mold, but also your coaster. Very pretty. I love both sides. There you can see it a little bit closer. Very sparkly. This is the bottom side of the coasters, and this one side I prefer to use, the top side. Very nice. Now I'm going to show you how I finish the sides. I'm using a Krylon liquid leaf marker, and I'm using it in a color gold. There you can see it. So with this marker, I'm making a line on top of the coaster. And I do this before adding the heat resistant layer, what I just mentioned, because then the top is totally protected. And so far I'm liking this marker, works very well. And the crystal effect in the middle is amazing. Very nice. And for sure I'm going to make more coasters with this effect in the middle. And I'm so proud of myself that I made my own silicon molds. Yeah, I'm also going to add the liquid leaf on the sides. There you can see it also with the marker. Works very well. So normally you would use the coasters on the top side, because the bottom side has the dip of the silicon mold. But also that side looks amazing. In the close-up you can see it much better. And I also want to mention that I'm going to add new colors to my pigment line, not only pastes, but also mica pigments. I'm going to add a copper, and that copper behaves like copper leaf, so it will float on top of your resin. And also a silver that behaves the same way, but also two other silver colors that are very sparkly, they are really nice. And I'm going to add two purple colors, really nice purple shades, a yellow one, and also a plum. And this plum color has no sparkle, so I also like to use colors without a sparkle. So I'm very excited to add all these new colors to my pigment line. So that's coming up. I will show you that in a video. So this is the end result, and this is the front side, so how I poured it, and I'm so happy how they turned out. They are really beautiful, and the effect in the middle, the crystal effect, is amazing. It's so nice, and it looks very real to me. looks almost like a real crystal. So I'm very pleased how these coasters turned out. So I would prefer to use it on this side. But the other side, I will show you also a close-up of the other side, is also very beautiful. So let me know what you think of my coasters. And if you like the front or the back of the coasters better, this is the back side. So very nice effects. Maybe, you can add a candle on top of it. I don't know. But I like them very much. So let me know what you think of these coasters. And if you like it very much, please give me a thumbs up for this video. It would help my channel a lot. Don't forget my promo codes. It's in the description box. Also, the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. And they are also available in the USA and Canada. Also, the link to that Etsy shop is in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!